गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स இன்னைக்கு நம்ம 8th சாப்டர்ல ரெகுலேஷன் ஆஃப் தி கிட்னி ஃபங்க்ஷன் பார்க்கறோம் ADH அண்ட் டயாபெட்டஸ் இன்சிபிடஸ் தி ஃபங்க்ஷனிங் ஆஃப் தி கிட்னிஸ் இஸ் எஃபிஷியன்சி மானிட்டர் அண்ட் ரெகுலேட்டட் பை தி ஹார்மோனல் ஃபீட்பேக் கண்ட்ரோல் மெக்கானிசம் இன்வால்விங் தி ஹைபோதாலமஸ் அண்ட் ஜெக்ஸ்ட்ரா கிளாமருலார் அப்பாரட்டஸ் அண்ட் டு சர்டைன் எக்ஸ்டெண்ட் தி ஹார்ட் சொல்லலாம் தி ஆஸ்மோ ரிசெப்டர் இன் தி ஹைபோதாலமஸ் ஆர் ஆக்டிவேட்டட் பை தி சேஞ்சஸ் இன் தி பிளட் வால்யூம் body fluid volume and ionic concentration when there is excessive loss of fluid from the body when there is an increase in the blood pressure and the asthma receptors of the hypothalamus respond by stimulating the neurohypophysis to secrete the antidiuretic hormone or vasopressin that means positive feedback mechanism and ADH facilitates the reabsorption of water by increasing the number of aquaporins on the cell surface membrane at the distal conduit tube and collecting duct the increase aquaporins causes the movement of water from the lumen into the interstitial cells thereby preventing the excessive loss of water by the diuresis when you drink excess amount of favorite juice asthma receptor of hypothalamus no longer stimulated to the and releases அந்த ஏடிஎச் சப்ரெசிவர் அந்த நியூரோ ஹைபோபோசிஸ் தட் இஸ் கால்ட் நெகட்டிவ் ஃபீட்பேக் மெக்கானிசம் அண்ட் அக்கோபரின்ஸ் ஆஃப் த கலெக்டிங் டக்ட் மூவ் இன்டு த சைட்டோபிளாசம் திஸ் மேக்ஸ் கலெக்டிங் டக்ட் இம்ப்ரிமியபிள் டு வாட்டர் எக்ஸஸ் ஃபுல்லிட் டவுன் டு கலெக்ட் தட் டக்ட் வித்தவுட் எனி வாட்டர் லாஸ் ஹென்ஸ் த டைலூட் யூரின் இஸ் ப்ரொடியூஸ் டு மெயின்டைன் த பிளட் வேல்யூ ஸோ வாசோபிரசின் secretion is controlled by positive and negative feedback mechanism okay so defect in ADH receptors or inability to secrete the ADH leads to a condition that is called as diabetes insipidus characterized by the excessive thirst and excretion of the large quantity of dilute urine and resulting dehydration and fall in the blood pressure the next one renin angiotensin mechanism juxtamedullary apparatus is a specialized tissue in the afferent arteriole of the nephron that consists of macula tensa and granular cells so macula tensa cells sense a distal tubular flow and affect the afferent arterial diameter whereas the granular cells secrete the enzyme that is called renin so a fall off in glomerular blood flow glomerular blood pressure and glomerular filtration rate can activate the extraglomerular cells to release renin which convert into plasma protein angiotensinogen to angiotensin 1 so angiotensin converting enzyme convert to angiotensin 1 to angiotensin 2 angiotensin 2 stimulate the potassium ions reabsorption in the proximal conduit tubule by the vasoconstriction of the blood vessel and increase glomerular blood pressure angiotensin 2 act as a at different sites such as heart kidney brain adrenal cortex and the blood vessels it stimulates the adrenal cortex to secrete the aldosterone that causes reabsorption sodium ions and potassium ions excretion and absorption of the water from the distal conduit tubule and collecting duct சொல்லலாம் this is increase the glomerular blood pressure and the glomerular filtrate rate also the complex mechanism that is known only known as renin angiotensin aldosterone system RAAS shows ischemic representation of the various hormones in regulation of the body fluid concentration solla next paathina atrial natric factor paakrom excessive stretch of cardiac atrial cells cause increase in blood flow to the atria of the heart and release atrial natric peptide of our factor NF travel to the kidney where the increase the sodium ions excretions and increase the blood flow up to the glomerulus acting an afferent glomerulus artery as a vasodilator or afferent arterioles as a vasoconstrictor ரத்த நாளங்களை சுருக்கிறது மற்றும் விரிக்கிறதுன்னு சொல்றோம் it decreases the aldosterone release from the arterial cortex and also decreases the release of renin thereby decreasing angiotensin 2 so and always act and antagonistically againstly solla antagonistically renin angiotensin system and aldosterone and vasopressin appo solla next we the mic duration paakrom the process of release of urine from bladder is called mic duration or urination solla Urine formed by the nephrons is ultimately carried to the urinary bladder, where it is stored till it receives the voluntary signal from the central nerve system. Stress receptor present in the urinary bladder are stimulated when it gets filled with the urine. Stretching of the urinary bladder stimulates the CNS via the sensory neuron or parasympathetic nerve system and bring about the contraction of the bladder simultaneously. Somatic nerve motor neurons also induce sphincter to close. So, smooth muscles contract resulting in the opening of the internal sphincters passively and relaxing the external sphincter. When the simultaneity of the inhibitory control also exerts a threshold, sphincter open and urine is expelled out. In adult human is an average excrete 1 to 1.5 liter urine per day. The urine formed a yellow color watery fluid, lightly acidic in nature, pH range is 6.0 also. So changes in diet may cause pH to vary between 4.5 to 8.0 as characteristic odor. So the yellow color of urine due to presence of pigment that is known as urochrome, important note for me, is an average 25 to 30 gram of urea also present in the urine excreted by day. Various metabolic disorder can affect the composition of urine. Analysis of urine help in clinical diagnosis of various metabolic disorder and malfunction of the kidneys. For example, presence of glucose, glycosuria, and ketone bodies, ketonuria, and urine in the urine indicate the diabetes mellitus. The next one, role of other organ in excretion. Apart from the kidneys, organs such as lungs, liver, and help to remove the wastes also. Our lungs remove the large quantity of carbon dioxide, 18 liters per day, and significant quantities of water every day. Liver secretes the bile containing substances like bilirubin and bilirubin, cholesterol, steroid hormones, vitamins, and drugs, which are excreted out along with the digestive wastes. Sweat and the sebaceous gland is skin eliminate the certain wastes through the secretions. Sweat produced by the sweat gland primarily help to cool the body, secondly excrete the sodium and potassium, small quantities of urea and lactate. Sebaceous gland eliminate then certain substances like sterols, hydrocarbon and waxes through the sebum that provide the protective oil covering from the skin. The small quantity of nitrogenous waste is also excreted through the saliva also. Okay, students, very nice revision panikinga. Next week ana ungalkana weekly test portion idha clear ah padichinga. Okay, thank you, friends.